your take on the popular view that COVID-19 was invented to maintain the balance in the population by getting rid of the senior citizen. How far is it true?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Can you tell me the question again, please?
Sure, sir. Sir, what is your take on the popular view that COVID-19 was invented to maintain the balance in population by getting rid of the senior citizen? How far is it true? Sujata Pradhan asks this question to you, sir. As a keynote speaker, you are supposed not to answer question, but I am requesting you.
It's okay. Yeah. No, very much. Thank you for asking Dr. Sujata, who raised this question. You know that during this COVID situation at this moment, if we think that who are the more vulnerable population age groups. So in terms of even for Bangladesh also, I was looking through the data of India too. So we have seen that much more infections are happening to the young or youth age group. But in terms of death rate, but if you think about the death rate, that's why it's much more confined to the elderly population, but old age population age group. There's no doubt sometimes if any crisis moment happen in a society, we see that if we think about the who are the more vulnerable age group, then definitely we think that elderly populations, they are getting the much more vulnerable aspects. And during this COVID too, I'm working on a research project actually with how the elderly peoples are facing discrimination also in the society in terms of the COVID situation. So like, you know, that how they are being treated in their family level, and not only in the family level, the family to whom we think that this is the loving and caring place. So some of the evidences and news media reported that elderly people are not treated in a good manner. Even they didn't get enough supports from the state level also, and also for the healthcare services level. So regarding the testing, regarding taking the care, and also some kind of social, how did I say, stigmatization. So some kind of stigma, because the COVID is the new phenomena here. So some people at the very beginning, the people are not much more aware about this issue. At that time, we find some kind of stigma related there. So in terms of care issue, particularly for the older population, we have seen some kind of not desirable attitude. But even for the state level, you think that elderly people or old population, they are the senior citizens. If you think in that way, they have their own rights perspectives, how the state is capable to support them, how much money social security supports are giving them. So every country, I think South Asian country, even India too, Bangladesh too, I think that they are offering some kind of support. But are these well enough? That is another one question. So how their livelihood pattern is going on? We need a quality elderly peoples there. As I showed in my model, that means a demographic transition model, once upon a time, the older people will be increased much more higher. And then we have a chance to achieve the goal of second demographic dividend. How is possible? If it is possible, if we can invest on health, if we find a healthy elderly people, old population, that means my life expectancy is increasing. This doesn't mean that my healthy life is increasing. So what we need to do, that means if we can ensure that healthy life, and then elderly people can also contribute to the economy, and not only for the economy, also for the social aspects, also for other policy-making, decision-making process. So during this COVID situation, particularly what I'm saying that at this moment, everyone from us, from the right perspective, or whether we are as a citizen perspective, we need to think about to ensure the rights of every people. But popular perceptions, I always think that elderly people are vulnerable because there are some groups of vulnerable peoples are living in our society, some disadvantaged population, because they have social security supports are not strong enough, pension schemes are not well enough, and nuclear family is predominating, and sons and daughters, those who are living in the urban area, and parents are living in the rural area. So who will take care of them? It is the society, it is the institution, it is the state who will take care of these, not only making a policy like, you know, senior citizen, but this is one verbal word, but in reality, in terms of quality of elderly people's life, I think that we much more need to think to do about these issues, because global global population is aging in coming times, as I told you in that way. And COVID, I think that in COVID situations, well, even the data, what we have received at this moment, that is also questionable in some way. That means whether these are really reflecting the true situation in that society. But some qualitative studies and also for perceptions, the popular perceptions of what's happening there, we found that elderly people are really vulnerable in terms of taking care and also in terms of taking treatment or in terms of ensuring their good, decent life.
Thank you, sir, for your answer, sir. You are tirelessly presenting also, and you are answering the participant, and they are very excited that you are be with us, and everyone was appreciating your lecture, sir. And thank you. And now, no question, I think. No question, sir. And thank you very much.